Everybody, it's me again. So today's photo shoot's gonna be about my friend. She's a dancer for this lingerie store downtown. And what she does is that she dances in the store's display window, basically trying to promote the store and trying to get people to come in and to check it out. So she does this while wearing the store's lingerie. So she's actually very brave, and I really admire her for that. And actually, she does a really good job at it. It was my first time seeing her when I went out to shoot her, and at first I was kind of embarrassed because I never saw her like this, and I didn't know if I should look at her or not, but she's actually really good, so way to go. But the main challenge to me was composition. I didn't want to just take like a straight on shot of like the store's facade and her dancing in the window. Nothing simple, so I had to work with composition. And that is thinking of different angles, perspectives, thinking of different elements I can add in my overall shot to try to render the photo more original. And yeah, so that was the main thing that was on my mind. So I'll be showing you some photos that I took along with the thought process behind how I was trying to compose my pictures. And at the end, I have a little slideshow of my favorite photos from the shoot. So, I hope you guys enjoy, and hope to see you next time. Take care. So here's the store. You can see her dancing on the left side. That's her in the left window pane. And it's just a straightforward picture. Pretty simple. Here it is edited. This one's a bit closer. Once again, it's just really simple. Here there's a tree, just to give a bit more dimension and depth to the photo. And I liked her pose here, so I think I'm gonna zoom in like this. They're playing around with the composition here, adding some cars, but don't really like it. This one's just okay, maybe I can make it in black and white. This one, I wanted to add a person walking in the front to give more dimension to the photo, and a slow shutter speed to catch her motion. I like the girl's poses here, they're both facing each other, and there's a man on the left side watching. This one, her pose is kinda cool. I really wanted to capture the idea of people driving by, but looking at the dancer in the window. So here's a bit lighter. Okay, this is exactly what I was going for. The man here, he's clearly looking at the dancer while he's driving, and she's making eye contact with him as well. And there's a sense of irony in this photo because the name of the store is Misbehavin', and it's almost like he's misbehaving while he's driving. And to me, that makes good street photography because of the humor. Here's another one. I kind of like her pose here. This one, I tried to shoot her through his window. It's kind of weird, but yeah, let's get rid of it. This one I like because she's in the middle of dancing, and the man in the car, he's just enjoying the show. I'm trying to use the bike in the front just to make a more interesting composition, but I don't really like this one. A bit closer up, I think it's better this way. How about a vertical shot? Meh. I really like her pose here and the passersby in front, so let's zoom in a bit. There you go. I like the idea of this scene. The man seems so unassuming and not aware of what's going on behind him. Added a tree in front to make it a bit more interesting. The tree in the foreground separates us from the subjects and gives a kind of spying or stalking feeling. Now let's try to get a different angle. This one doesn't have anything really interesting about it. Neither does this one, nor this one. Bingo! I really love this perspective, because here you can see the people walking by, you can see the street, and it looks like she's a mannequin in the window, she's just part of the store. I love this because you see her curvy body to the side, and then you see the rest of the street, so it's really subtle. Now let's take some shots of her dancing. This is alright. That's alright. That's alright. Meh. No, not really this one. Let's try to do something different. Let's take some up-close shots like this. There we go, I really like this one actually. But the background's a bit distracting. There we go, this is more dramatic. And here's more close-up ones. Yep, voila, I love this one. I love her pose here, I love her facial expression, I love the little smile in her mouth, I love the space on the left side of her. Here's another body shot. I love this one because you can see her reflection in the window, and it's like she's checking herself out or admiring herself. So I want to bring out this reflection even more, so I'll make it in black and white. So there's only two tones to focus on. I love how busy this photo seems, and I love her dancing here, but it's a bit too busy, so I'm gonna make it black and white.
This photo is one of my favorite. I really love her pose here. You can see the muscular contours. And there's this rock star feeling to this photo. It's like this is her stage, and in front of her it's just this big, vast emptiness. Now here's another point of view. I don't really like it, but I want to try to make use of that gate there. Let's try to shoot through it. This one, it's okay. She looks cute here, but I don't like how she's parallel with the gate. I don't like this one either. Neither this one. I want to change the focus here. I'm going to focus on the gate instead and just put her out of focus in the background. Something like this. She's a bit out of focus, but it keeps it subtle and sultry. And it's a bit more sexy this way, I think. I love her facial expression here, and I love how the bars in the front make her seem inaccessible to us, like she's locked away. Here I try to make use of the gate. It looks kind of silly, but I think it makes the photo more interesting. At the end, I just edit the photos in Adobe Lightroom, just to help bring out the best of them. And at the end, there will be a little montage of my favorite photos from the shoot. So I hope you guys enjoy the show, and until next time!
You got